This is one of the new locations. There's actually a pipe right here. It's supposed to be going, good sized pipe. They've got it dammed up. It's just going over the top of it. Here, because that's going to start to slow down. Look at the pipe now. Got it opened. real good whirlpool action there. Goes outflow. It's mainly switched to the pipe now. That is the secondary dam right there. Took that one out last week. Fortunately, I didn't have cameras, so wasn't expecting to find it. Really strong current on that. Back as I can see, just stuff just rushing this way, debris and stuff. Getting down to just a trickle here, and what's going over the top, so dropping fast. Real good flower. Look at how over here on the dam, we're just down to a trickle now. It's barely coming over. The pipe's doing all the heavy lifting now. I mean, it's even dropping from that fast too. Looking just in the time I turned over to that, now look at this. That's beaver gnawing. And look how high up on that tree he's been gnawing. That's probably not a small beaver. Flow over the road here now is pretty much all but gone, just a slight trickle. I know they'll dam this up again, so they'll have to be addressed. That's gonna be kind of one of the spots they go after. Probably go after it tonight. I'll probably try and fill it back in. Just a couple minutes later, pretty much no more water running over. That sucks it did that. It sucks that it did that there, because that was our road through here. It was already kind of steep. You can see the grate has been removed, didn't get put back in place.
So all the debris is right here at the pipe. Also, because the excavator, backhoe, whatever they used, but they scooped this out here, and our little places where we would stand on down there are gone. So I know somewhere right out about that white pipe was the old foundation of the Beaver Dam, so I may be able to stand on that with some decent stability, but that's pretty far away from where I need to get here. So I may try to start by pulling some of this stuff out from up top here if I can, at least enough to open it up a little bit more and see if we can get the water down some, and get the grate somewhat back in place. I was talking to a trapper about the beaver situation, about trying to attract them so that they could be, you know, dealt with. And the trapper said to use, that they're drawn to the color blue. Dad asked me about it. I never heard anything like that, but I figured, well, if that's true, then surely you could probably go on the internet and research it. And I didn't find anything. But it was kind of odd. Dad used to have a blue truck, and he could pull up here on this right here and sit and park, and the beavers would swim down here. So I don't know if it's coincidental or if there really is something about the color blue. Let me know if you've ever heard of beavers being attracted to the color blue. Comment, let me know. Of all the times that I've been out here, been coming out here doing this, I've never seen a beaver. I'm wearing blue today, as a matter of fact. I've heard them splash, but I've never seen a beaver. I'm not worried about this stuff here. To clean it better. And I'm just going to put that there, like that for now, so we don't get more debris in there, big stuff, because I see, looks like some stuff making its way this way. All right, so we'll let this one go. We're definitely going to, I've got more work to do here, so we're not done. Good flow. All right, so now we'll go back here and we'll look at these that have to pertain with the backfield and the woods and see what's going on there. All the places, I mean, the water's so high everywhere today. One of the places I expected to be bad was here, but it's really not too bad. It's starting to get back into those ditches into the woods, but it's not in the woods yet. It's not, don't have trees underwater, so this is definitely plugged up. I don't know how much flow we're going to see, because obviously the back side of it is pretty full too. It just sucks because this was totally dry last week and we had a pretty significant amount of rain. That one a little bit. Yeah, this is definitely flowing over here. Man, this is a big piece of metal here. Yeah, there's a little bit more over there. You can tell by the mud there, it's definitely flowing. We just need to go down on the other side to, but it's flowing good. It's just, it's all underwater, so you really don't get the rushing water sound and such. But we do have, oh, here we go. Yeah, now it's coming through. Good deal. So it's about the same here. clogged up, water really high, just to the point that it's getting through because it's just high. So get this cleared out, see if we can get that flowing a little bit better. Let's look at the other side first. Flowing pretty good. It's really not bad, but I think it can be. It's a big pipe. I think it can handle more, so we're gonna give it more. That was an easy one too, relatively speaking. It was already going, just had to kind of get the stuff out of the way. Oh yeah. Using probably, I don't know, just around 2/3 of that pipe's capacity. Pretty decent flow already coming through there, but it is badly clogged. So we're gonna get it better. Looks like it's broken through part of it there. Thank you.
Okay. That's a good start for that one. We'll let that chew on that for a while. Once this comes down some, we'll probably have to be able to get in, kind of dig it out even deeper. I don't think it's quite down to the bottom of the grate, so it'll come out some more, but we'll let that go and get it moving some other places. Here's the outflow side now. Big improvement. It's really moving some water, so.
Look at the size of that shell there. Well, I don't know what that is. There's another one there too. I don't know what they're called. Mussels or whatever. But yeah, so these waders, Boxelli, I think is what they're called. They're actually intended, or you know, they're outdoor gear, but mainly targeted towards people that fish. They're neoprene. Wasn't really what I was looking for. I wanted something that was like waist level. I wanted something more than just the ones like Dad has that come up to here. I wanted something waist. Well, I wear a size 14. So when you're talking about a shoe size, it's a size 14. After a size 13, your options drastically fall. So, but I found these, they do work good. If you saw the video a few weeks back of the where it was sponsored by Brunt, they actually, so for doing that sponsorship, of course, they gave me a pair of boots, which was awesome. They also gave me $100. So with that $100, I took it and I bought these because these were $100. So putting the money right back in. So hopefully it makes this more interesting and more people want to watch and enjoy. So look at how much that's already dropped. You can see the water mark on there from the debris on the white.
Falling quite a bit. Hopefully we should be able to see the pipe and stuff here for long.
Here's a wheat update, if you're following along with that. It's really kind of shot up. Last weekend I noticed it had really kind of darkened up and was really kind of starting to fill out. And a week later, and I think it's probably put on 2 inches of growth or more. So coming along.